The ear converts sound waves into nerve impulses, and it's also responsible for our sense of equilibrium and movement. The structures in the ear are divided into three categories: the outer ear, the middle ear, and the inner ear. Let's go through them one by one and learn more about ear anatomy. The outermost part of the ear is the auricle, also known as the external ear or the pinna. The auricle is made of cartilage covered in thin skin and is made up of parts like the helix, lobule, and tragus. The auricle amplifies sound and helps the brain determine the source of the sound. After bouncing around the auricle, sound is funneled through the external acoustic meatus, the skin-covered passageway that comes to an end at the tympanic membrane. Sound causes the tympanic membrane, also known as the eardrum, to vibrate. Those vibrations then travel into the middle ear. The tympanic chamber of the middle ear is a hollow chamber filled with air. Attached to the tympanic chamber is the eustachian tube, the tube that connects the tympanic chamber to the nasopharynx of the upper respiratory system. When you swallow or yawn, the eustachian tube opens and equalizes the air pressure in the middle ear with the air pressure outside. In the tympanic chamber, there are three bones called the ossicles. The three ossicles are the malleus, incus, and stapes, also known as the hammer, anvil, and stirrup. The malleus is attached to the tympanic membrane. The malleus receives vibrations from the tympanic membrane and transfers them to the incus, which transmits them to the stapes. From the stapes, vibrations move to the oval window, a membrane-covered opening between the stapes and the cochlea, located in the inner ear. The middle ear also contains the round window, another membrane-covered opening that allows the fluid in the cochlea to move with the vibrations transmitted through the ossicles. The inner ear is responsible for a sense of balance in addition to hearing. It contains a system of tubes and sacs called the membranous labyrinth. This system is contained within the system of bony structures called the osseous labyrinth. The osseous labyrinth is divided into the vestibule, cochlea, and the semicircular canals. The vestibule is a chamber at the center of the osseous labyrinth. The semicircular canals are a series of three canals that connect to the vestibule in a total of five places. Each canal has an ampulla at each end, an expansion that contains fluid and hair cells. When the head rotates or moves, the fluid causes the hair cells to move. The vestibular nerves transmit impulses from the movement of the hair cells to the brain, giving the brain information about acceleration, deceleration, and equilibrium. The cochlea is shaped like a spiral, and it connects to the vestibule, where it picks up on the vibrations sent through the oval window into the inner ear. When the oval window moves due to vibration, fluid pressure builds in the cochlea and activates the hair cells within. The cochlear nerves transmit the impulses to the brain. Want to learn more about ear anatomy? Visible Body Suite has all the 3D gross and microanatomy models and physiology animations you need, as well as 3D flashcard decks for studying. Learn more at visiblebody.com/VBSuite.